सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यम अस्मदाचार्यपर्यंता वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यव्रतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ओं सहनावतु सहनौ हुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओं शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। ओं यो ब्रह्माण विदाति पुरो वेदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंह देवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ओं शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्नायान्तिक संसिद्धम् आधिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। कंटिन्यूइंग विद दी नेक्स्ट अधिकरण विच इज उपसंहाराधिकरण दी वृत्ति सेज पूर्व सर्वशाखासु विज्ञेयम् अवादी अधुना तत्फलम् उच्यते इति फलफली भाव संगत्या इदम् आह। व्हाट वाज डन अर्लियर एज वी हैव सीन दी गुण उपसंहारा वाज डन अक्रॉस शाखास ड्यू टू द्रव्य नाम नाम्या मीनिंग समाख्या नाम समाख्या सच काइंड ऑफ गुणास बीइंग सेम इवन इफ देर इज अ लिटिल भेद अक्रॉस शाखाज उपासनास आर सेम एंड देन गुण उपसंहार शुड बी डन मीनिंग यू शुड क्लब टुगेदर द धर्माज विच आर डिस्कस्ड और द स्वरूप इत्यादि विच इज डिस्कस इन दी उपासनाज अक्रॉस शाखास दी शुड बी क्लब टुगेदर। सो पूर्व सर्वशाखासु विद्यैक्यम विद्या मीन उपासना उपासना इज वन एंड दी सेम दिस वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड। नाउ अधुना तत्फलम उच्यते वॉट इज दी रिजल्टेंट ऑफ दैट वेन यू क्लब टुगेदर दी उपासना गुणास फ्रॉम डिफरेंट शाखास एंड मेक इट अ सिंगल उपासना what is the resultant this is discussed in this particular adhikarana therefore the phala phali bhava sangati the earlier adhikarana is phali phalamasya asti iti phali that which has this adhikarana is a phala that which has this adhikarana as a phala is a phali so earlier adhikarana is phali and this adhikarana is phala discussion basically phala meaning discusses the phala This adhikarana itself is not the phala. This adhikarana discusses the phala for the phali which is discussed in the earlier adhikarana where upasana gunas have been clubbed together. Thereby, this adhikarana comes up upasamhara adhikaranam and Bhagavan Sutrakara says upasamharvartha bhedad vidhi visheshavat samane cha upasamharvartha bhedad vidhi visheshavat samane cha समाने सो उपसंहारः अर्थाभेदात् अर्थाना अर्थस्य अभेदात् अर्थाभेदात् विधिशेषवत् समाने च दैट इज द पदच्छेद सो उपसंहारः समाने कर्मणि यथा तथा सो द एग्जांपल गिवन इज कर्म How guna upasamhara is done with similar karmas across shakhas, so too in samana upasanas gunana upasamhara kartavya. So samane karmani yatha gunana upasamhara kartavya atva yuktaha tatha samane upasane cha upasamhara gunana upasamhara yuktaha kartavya. What is the hetu for that? Artha bhedat. अर्थस्य प्रयोजनस्य अभेदात् बिकॉज ऑफ अभेद इन प्रयोजन दि प्रयोजन ऑफ वन कर्म इन वन शाखा इज सेम एज दि प्रयोजन ऑफ सिमिलर कर्म इन अनदर शाखा देयरफॉर बोथ दि कर्मास आर सेम एंड देन all that is necessary has to be clubbed together from both the shakhas or multiple shakhas into a single karma. Why? Because the result is same. Whether you do karma as discussed, Agnihotra discussed in one shakha, or you do Agnihotra discussed in another shakha, the result is same, Swarga Prapti. So these two have to be clubbed together. Multiple shakha discussions of Agnihotra are the discussions of same Agnihotra. It is a single karma. Therefore, they should be clubbed together and made as a single karma. So to what should you do with Upasana? Upasanas which are discussed across multiple shakhas also having the same result, you have to bring them together. Abhedad. Why? Vidhi Visheshavat. Example is given Vidhi Sheshavat. So Vidhi Shesha is there. Vidhi is seen. We have seen a little bit in Arthasangraha. Whenever a Vidhi is being discussed, if the sentence Akanksha is not complete, you have to bring it from the other. Shruti Linga Prakarana Ityadi. Therefore, Vidhi Shesha is found in another Shakha. Meaning a part of the Shesha of the Vidhi is discussed in another Shakha. That also has to be brought together because it is a single karma with a single result. This is the Sutrartha. अत्र पूर्वपक्षे पूर्वाधिकरणस्य विवक्षित फलासिद्धिः सिद्धान्ते तस्य तत्सिद्धिरिति फलभेदः. सो पूर्वपक्ष हैज पूर्वपक्षी सेइंग पूर्व अधिकरणस्य विवक्षित फल असिद्धि. व्हाट इज विवक्षित फल? व्हाट इज इंटेंडेड रिजल्ट एज पर द अर्लियर अधिकरण? गुण उपासंहार. दैट इज द not the phala of the karma or the upasana. What is the resultant of your mimamsa, the analysis that you have done in the earlier adhikarana? Siddhanti says that our analysis phala is that guna upasamhara has to be done. Across shakhas, upasana gunas have to be clubbed together because it is a single upasana. So whether it is brihat or chandogya, both have to be clubbed together into one upasana. Siddhanti has made this claim and he has established also. Purvapakshi says that Vivakshita Phala Asiddhihi, this Guna Upasamhara is not possible in Upasana. Siddhanti Tasya Tatsiddhi Tasya, Tasya meaning Purvadhikaranasya, Tatsiddhi is Vivakshita Phala Siddhi. Definitely Guna Upasamhara has to be done is the claim of the Siddhanti, which is being asserted further in this Adhikarana. सर्वत्र उपासनानां एकत्वेपि एकशाखास्थ विद्यायां शाखांतरस्थ अधिक गुणानां उपसंहार अस्ति न वा इति संदेहे. यत्र यावन्तो गुणाः श्रुताः तैः एव आकांक्षा शान्तेः न उपसंहार इति पूर्वपक्ष. वेर इज द पूर्वपक्षी कमिंग फ्रॉम? इन एनालिसिस, इन मीमांसा ऑफ एनी वाक्य, वेर इज द analysis going to conclude where there is akanksha shanti? Let's say I just make a statement in the vakya, Ramaha gachati. Ekatinga vakyam, Rama is going is sufficient, but there is an akanksha that can be raised. What is the akanksha? Putra gachati, Ramaha putra gachati. So it has to be supplied with vanam. So if the sentence is Ramaha gachati, if the akanksha is there kutra gachati, then vanam can be supplied as a separate sentence. Or there can be a sentence as to vanam gachati, saha vanam gachati. So saha, who is that saha? Saha has to be one with Rama because the sarvanama has an akanksha associated as to which is the nama. Kaha saha? So Ramaha by the earlier vakya. Even if it is separated by one or more vakyas, in the same prakarana you have to connect them together. In the same paragraph you find it, in a story kind of a scenario, this is an example. Thereby there is eka vakyata between the first vakya Ramaha gachati and the second vakya vanam gachati or saha vanam gachati. There is eka vakyata. And if you take it in the vidhi, the first vakya will have vidhi shesha in the second vakya. So vidhi shesha vat said Bhagavan Sutrakara in the sutra. Now Purvapakshi is saying only if there is an akanksha, then you need vidhi shesha. You will look for vidhi shesha, but the vidhi akanksha is over in the Brihat Shakha or the Chandogya Shakha independently. So if in one single shakha Rupasana is being discussed, there is no akanksha left for you to look around in another shakha as to what else has to be added into this Upasana. There is no guna akanksha at all. Guna nam akanksha eva nasti. Then why do you say that there is vidhi sheshavat, you have to look for another shakha, gunas also, and club together in a single upasana? This is where the Purvapakshi is coming from. So sarvatra upasananam ekatve api. Even if you have established in the earlier adhikarana as there is a single goal in Vedanta, so vidya ekatvam has to be accepted. Upasana are going to be same because the resultant finally is what? Is this abheda between jiva and brahma. This is what your claim has been. So you are saying that the upasanas which are connected in aikya, which is the tatparya vishaya of sarva vedanta vakya, all vedanta vakyas, their dwaribhuta are these upasanas which provide ekagrata, chitta ekagrata, and chitta ekagrata dwara aikya siddhi, jiva brahma aikya siddhi, this has been your process of thinking. You, the Siddhanti, has been thinking in this manner. Said the Purvapakshi, sarvatra upasanaram ekatvepi. Even so, ekashakasta vidyayam shakantarasta adhika gunana upasamahara astinavaiti sande. Now, if you consider this upasana in one shakha, vidya is upasana there. Ekashakasta, ekashakayam tishtati, eka is shakha. So in a single shakha, eka shakhayam tishtati, ya vidya sa vidya is upasana, ya vidya sa eka shakha vidya, tasyam eka shakhastha vidyayam shakhantarastha adhika gunana upasamhara astinava. Whether you should club together gunas, swarupa of the upasana in another shakha into this shakhastha upasana or not, when such a doubt comes up, astinava iti sande, yatra yavanta gunaha shrutaha. So whichever is the guna, set of gunas heard in one shakha, taihi eva akanksha shantehe. So if you belong to the vajasaniya shakha and there is an upasana discussed there, the gunas are discussed there, so you will have heard them. When you learn them, gunaha shrutaha yavanta, only those much have been heard. And taiyeva akanksha shante, how should you do this upasana? These are the gunas, this is how you do it. These are the gunas of the upasya devata. Then akanksha is shanta. How do you do the upasana? In which manner should you look at the upasya devata? In this manner, hiranyashmashruhu ityadi. With a golden mustache, this adityagata purusha is there. You have your upasana in this manner, you will get certain phala. This has been discussed. So where is the akanksha further? So taihi eva akanksha shanti he na upasamhara iti purvapaksha. Then there is no akanksha left to hunt around other gunas of this upasana in another shakha, said the purvapakshi. Siddhantastu, Siddhanti says samane upasane guna upasamhara yuktaha. So gunana upasamhara is definitely tenable because the upasana discussed across two different shakhas are the same upasanas. They are similar, samana. Kutaha? Why should you do so? Ask the Purvapakshi to that. Arthabhedat. Says the Siddhanti as an answer. Upasya gunaihi nirvartyasya upasana rupartasya sarva shakhasu abhinnatvat. So arthasya abhedat. Arthasya prayojanasya abhedat. Because the prayojana of the upasana in Vajasaniya Shakha is same as the prayojana of the upasana in the Chandogya Shakha. As an example, so arthabhedat, arthanam, arthayoho abhedat, prayojana yoho abhedat. The prayojana in one shakha for this upasana is same as the prayojana for the samana upasana in the other shakha. So upasya gunaihi nirvartyasya, that which is accomplished. What is that? Upasana rupa arthasya. The upasana prayojana, the phala of the upasana, the result of the upasana is nirvartya, is accomplished by what? Upasya guna. With the gunas of the upasya devata. And they are same. The result discussed for an upasana in one shakha and another with some other gunas in another shakha, they are same. Prayojana is same, therefore sarva shakhasu avinnatvat. Not only in two shakhas, if there is a third shakha also, fourth shakha also, if it discusses a samana upasana and the phala is same, then you have to club together all the gunas into a single upasana, and every shakha follower has to do the upasana by borrowing gunas from the other shakhas for swashakha upasana siddhi. Tatra drishtanta, what is the example? Like what is this upasana guna upasanana guna upasamhara, upasanayoho gunana upasamhara? What is the drishtanta? Their example is vidisheshavat. Yatha agnihotrasya sarvatra ikyat tatsheshanam upasamhara tadvadityartha. So just like the vidishesha found in another shakha, which is the vidhi? Agnihotra vidhi. So agnihotra is an example of a vidhi given in swashakha, and you find agnihotra in another shakha also with the same result. Swarga is the phala there as well. Agnihotra is similar. There are some different followings in another shakha. You bring them together. Sarvatra ikyat tatsheshanam upasamharaha. So whatever is vidhishesha found in another vidhi in another shakha, another vidhi in the sense, another vidhi vakya, which is a part of agnihotra in another shakha, you bring that together and follow the agnihotra in your own shakha in that manner. Bring them together. Bring all the gunas together. So iti kartavyata can be clubbed together, said the Siddhanti. Now, Puropakshi comes up with another thought. Purvam chodanadya visheshat ityatra samakhyayaha avisheshat vidyaikyam iti uktam. In the earlier adhikarana, what have you done? In the first adhikarana, says the Puropakshi, chodanadya visheshat sutra was seen in that adhikarana because chodana adi, chodana samakhya meaning nama, swarupa, rupa meaning swarupa, all these are same in an upasana discussed in another shakha than yours, therefore you have to club together the gunas and consider both of them or multiple of these as a single upasana. Ityatra samakhyayaha avisheshat. In their adipada you had samakhya also. Samakhya means nama, name of the upasana is same. Name of the upasya may be same. So some name similarity, or not similarity, name is same across upasanas, across different shakhas. That also is one linga, one indicator to bring in gunas from different shakhas together and make it a single upasana. This is the claim you, the Siddhanti, has made, says the Puropakshi. Therefore, what vidyaikyam? Therefore, upasanas, vidyas, upasanas discussed across multiple shakhas are a single upasana iti uktam. Was stated by you, the Siddhanti. Tarhi atra api udghita vidya iti samakhyayaha avisheshad vidyaikyam eva iti drishtant sangatya idamaha. So this sutra which comes up is in Anyathatvadikarana. This Anyathatvadikarana, the first sutra is a Puropakshi sutra. Puropaksha sutra, Puropakshi is saying that because you have made a claim and established it well in Chodanadya Visheshat sutra, that nama, samakhya is one indicator to bring the gunas from another shakha antargata upasana into your own shakha antargata upasana. So guna upasamhara has to be done because of what reason? Vidya ikya. You have established vidya ikya, upasana ikya between the two. Now similarly here, udgita vidya, this udgita vidya, udgita we have seen earlier, udgita is a sama antargata, a particular omkara. In Samaveda, particular omkara upasana is taught, that is called as udgita. This omkara, particular part of a vakya omkara, that omkara is called as udgita. Now this udgita is the samakhya, is a name. And udgita is what? Udgita vidya is there, upasana of udgita. Now whether it is in Vajasaniya Brihatshaka or is it in whether it is in Chandogya Shaka, there is no difference between Udgita Vidya being the name there, Udgita. So Samakhya being the same, you have to club together the Upasana, says the Puro Pakshi, based on your own analysis that you have established in the first Adhikarana, you the Siddhanti, says the Puro Pakshi. So in Sama, we have seen earlier Samas, Pancha Bhaktika, Sapta Bhaktika, Bhaktika, etc. So there are 5 divisions in Sama or there are 7 divisions. So what happens in Pancha Bhaktika? Just a background to this, it's a little tricky there as to this Udgita. So in the Pancha Bhaktika Sama, Samni, Udgitam Tritiyam, that Udgita is the third. The Udgita occurs as the third. In the Sapta Bhaktika, the Udgita occurs in the fourth place. This much is sufficient information right now. So in Udgita also there are many aksharas in which one is an omkara. So Udgita is not necessarily, so Udgita is a sama antargata part in which there is one omkara. In many aksharas in Udgita, one omkara that is there, that part avayava omkara, there is avayava Udgita prayoga. So this Udgita, in unto that omkara there is a superimposition of Udgita, Udgitatvam. So this kind of an upasana is there. So a particular part of Sama in Pancha Bhaktika or Sapta Bhaktika, there is a division as to where this Udgita occurs. In that Udgita, one part is omkara, on that omkara there is an upasana of Udgita. This kind of a teaching, some similar teaching is there across Shakhas. So based on this, now we'll look at the next Adhikarana Sutra, first Sutra. So Atrapi Udgita Vidya iti Samakhyaya Avishesha, says the Purva Pakshi. The Samakhya, the name Udgita, in this Udgita Vidya is same. In the Upasana, Udgita name has been used. Therefore, we'll consider the two different two upasanas across two different shakas as one upasana. This is the claim of the Purva Pakshi based on the similar process of the Siddhanti made in the first Adhikarana. Avisheshad Vidya Aikyam, Upasana Aikyam. So Udgita Vidya will become one across both shakas. Eva iti Drishtanta Sangatya Devam. So example based on Siddhanta has been given by the Purva Pakshi in this Adhikarana. Therefore, there is a Drishtanta Sangati. अन्यथात्वाधिकरणम् दी पूर्वपक्षी सूत्र इज अन्यथात्वम् शब्दादिति चेन्ना विशेषात् अन्यथात्वम् शब्दादिति चेन्ना विशेषात् सो इति चेत् हियर दी पदच्छेद इज अन्यथात्वम् शब्दात् इति चेत् न अविशेषात् सो बीइंग अ पूर्वपक्षी सूत्र अन्यथात्वम् शब्दात् अन्यथात्वम् मीनिंग दी Vajasaneya antargata upasana and Chandogya antargata upasana, there is anyathatvam between them. They are different upasanas, says the Siddhanti now, not the Purva Pakshi. Siddhanti is saying there are exceptions to the rule. We have already seen earlier as to every upasana need not be the same. There is difference in upasanas also. Their goal is the same, but wherever there is upasana similarity due to Chodanadi, Vidhi, Swarupa, Samakhya, Ityadi, Dravya, when you see all of these are similar across Shakhas with a similar Upasana and a same result, Prayojana has to be same. Then what have we said? We have said there alone you have to club together all Gunas across Shakhas and make it as a single Upasana. We are not saying that all Upasanas are same. Even if there are differences, that is not the claim we have made. So Siddhanti says that there are exceptions to this. You have to analyze as to whether it is the same upasana or different upasana across shakhas. So anyathatvam, we are saying no, in this case there are two different upasanas in two different shakhas. Why shabda? We'll explain shabda. Shabda is the hetu there. Because the shabda you hear in one shakha versus in another shakha, they are different. The shruti itself is pramana there. Shabdas used are different. So there is no samakhya really that you are seeing. That does not become a hetu for vidya ikyam. There is vidya bheda. Iti chet, if this is a claim being made, then Purvapakshi says no. No. Why? Avisheshat. Because there is no difference between the two upasanas. How? We'll see in the vritti. This is the claim made by the Purvapakshi. So Siddhanti is saying these two upasanas are different. Purvapakshi is saying they are same. Just like you are claiming in the first adhikarana, we are also claiming this particular Udghita upasana is same across both shakhas. We look at the vritti. Bhagavan Sadashiva Brahmendra says, Atra Purvapakshe Mitho Gunopasamharaha. Mutually you have to bring in gunas from the other shakha to make this upasana complete, whichever shakha you belong to. Whether you are a Vajasaniya shakha follower or you are a Chandogya shakha follower, you have to bring the gunas from the other shakha into swashakha and do this Udghita Vidya upasana. Siddhante Vidyaikya Apavada. There is an apavada, there is an exception to this Vidyaikya we have claimed earlier in the first adhikarana. Now in this third adhikarana we will show that there is apavada. Apavada is an exception to the general rule. We have given the general setup, how you have to do an analysis. Now this is an exception. What you are bringing up is an exception to that, and therefore anupasamhara iti phala bheda. The result is that, or result of this analysis is that guna anupasamhara. You should not bring the gunas from the other shakha antargata upasana into your own shakha. In this particular case, vajasneyake pathyate atha hemasanyam pranamuchastvam na udgayeti tatheti tebhyesha prana udgayat iti. So Purvapakshi quotes this. In the Brihad Shakha, what do you hear? Atha ha imam asanyam pranam uchuhu. Uchustvam uchuhu. What tvam naha udgayeti? You do udgana. You prana. They told to prana. Pranam uchuhu. They told this asanya prana as what? Oh, you mukhya prana. What should you do? Udgana, do udgana. Tatha iti. So prana said tatha iti. Tebhyesha prana udgayata. And then this udgana has been done by prana. So prana devata did udgana in what? Vajasane shaka. What about, so Brihat shaka. In Chandogya, what is the case? Tatha Chandogya pi, says the Purvapakshi. In Chandogya also, what do you have in that shaka? Ataha ya evayam mukhya pranastad. Tam udgitam upasan chakrire iti mukhya prana parigraha krutaha. This mukhya prana is heard in the Chandogya also. You have heard prana in pranam uchuhu and pranaha udgayata. You have heard in Vajasaniya shakha, meaning Brihat shakha, you have this mantra, and then you have another upasana mantra in Chandogya which says what? Ataha yaha eva ayam mukhyaha pranaha tam udgitam upasan chakrire. Their pranaha tam. So mukhya prana tam udgitam. So that prana is to be seen as udgita in the upasana. Upasan chakrire. This is how the upasana has to be done. Prana is to be meditated upon as udgita. Purvapakshi says iti mukhya prana parigraha kruta. You see mukhya prana is heard in the Chandogya Shruti also, and you have this mukhya prana as one who did udgana in the Vajasane shakha. Iti ubhayatra api prana vidya vidhi avasiyate. This udgita vidya has been said in the introduction to this sutra. And within the sutra vritti, we are seeing prana vidya. So prana vidya is also heard. Therefore, prana becomes a linga as well, prana vidya. And that is the vidhi, upasana vidhi, prana vidya is prana upasana vidhi here now. So, avasiyate, this is what you conclude, that this is the prana vidya which is discussed in Chandogya. It cannot be different from the Brihad Shakha Antargata prana vidya, because prana word is heard there also. This is where the Purvapakshi is coming from. So, he says, kimatra vidya ikyam, is there is a upasana ikya, oneness between upasanas across these shakhas. Aosvita or what? Vidya bheda. Or there is upasana bheda. Iti samshe, when this doubt is there, vidya ikyam iti Purvapakshi. Purvapakshi has clearly claimed that there is vidya ikyam. Why? Because prana vidya is there, mukhya prana is heard in both places, you hear prana. Therefore, this mukhya prana, upasana in both shakhas have to be one. Now, the Siddhanti raises an objection to this. Nanu anyathattvam na vidyaikyam bhavitum arhati. There is difference in upasanas, therefore vidyaikya. There is no oneness between two upasanas in this case. It is not valid analysis, says the Siddhanti. Kutaha, why so? Tvam na udgaya. Iti udghita kartrutvena ekatra anyatra tam udghitam upasan chakrire. Why is there a difference? So this, by the way, yeah, this na is not na, okay? It is not na, it is naha. It is naha, visarga, there is visarga sandhi. So visarga is born due to sandhi there. Rather, visarga is not born due to sandhi. Tvam naha udgaya. You prana, he prana, tvam naha asmakam krite udgaya. Why don't you do udgana? Please do udgana for our sake. Claim the others to prana devata. This is in the Vajasaniya shakha. Iti udgita kartrutvena ekatra. Ekatra meaning where in Vajasaniya shaka. So in the Brihat shaka, you see prana is udgita karta. He did udgana. Anyatra, meaning in Chandogya shaka, tam udgitam upasan chakri re. Iti udgita tvena. In the Chandogya shaka, prana devata himself is udgita. Is the prana is upasya as udgita. So pranasya upasyatva pratipadakat. In the Brihat Shakha, you have Prana who is the Udgita Karta. And in the Chandogya Shakha, he is the Upasya as Udgita. How can you bring them together into one Upasana? Therefore, Anyathattvam says the Siddhanti. How can Udgita Gana Karta and Udgita itself be one? Udgita is not singing. That is what will be the end resultant if you club together both the upasanas. In one case, it has been said prana is the udgita gana karta. In the other chandogya, it has been said as upasana is in which manner? Not as prana should be meditated upon as the udgita gana karta, but in the chandogya, it is said as prana has to be meditated upon as what? As udgita itself. Therefore, anyatra tam udgitam upasan chakrire iti udgitatvena pranasya upasyatva pratipadakat. The shruti chandogya shruti reveals prana as the upasya devata, and he should be seen as this udgita of sama. This is the reason, shabdat iti chet. So why is there anyathattvam? Why is there a difference between chandogya, prana vidya and or Udghita Vidya and this Prana Vidya or Udghita Vidya of the Vajasane Shakha Shabdat. Due to Shabda Bheda, there is a difference in Shruti itself. And Shruti is this the most superior input for your analysis in Mimamsa. So, iti cheta, if this is the objection, Purvapakshi says, no, you should not bring that kind of a doubt up. Why? Naitavata Vidya Bheda. There is no difference in vidya, upasana established by this kind of a shabda. Kutaha, Purvapakshi says, Devasura sangrama upakrama suratyaya abhipraya pravrutinam ubhetra avisheshat. So his claim is, you look at the story there. We have seen this Prana story there. Deva Asura Sangrama. When there is a fight between Deva and Asura, Upakrama in the opening, Asura Atya Abhipraya Prabhuchinam. You look at all of these. They are discussed in both shakas. This story is there. In the Upakrama, there is this story of Deva Asura Sangrama Ityadi and Asura Atya Abhipraya. How this has come to a conclusion, if you look at it, there also you can see in both shakas, there is, you will lead with the, you will reach the conclusion as to what? There was a beginning of Devasura Sangrama and then Asura Chaya. Asuras have been defeated. And for that purpose, Asura Atya Abhipraya, for that purpose, what has been done? Samvada. This Samvada has come up. Abhipraya Pravritam Ubhayatra Vishesha. The Samvada which came up, Ubhayatra meaning in the Brihat Shaka as well as Chandogya Shaka, this story is common where for the purpose of defeating the Asuras, Pranadevata was approached and Pranadevata, the samvada between Pranadevata and others has come up in that context. Therefore, the story is similar there and the purpose is also similar. Purpose is to defeat the Asuras and therefore the samvada has come up whereby this Upasana is to be same. Ataha vidyaikyam iti siddham. Puropakshi is saying that is the same Upasana across both shakas. Evam Puropakshi Radhanta. Radhanta is Siddhanta we have seen earlier. Evam Puropakshi Prapti Sati. When this Puropaksha has come up, then Siddhanti gives the Sutra. Bhagavan Sutrakara says, Nava Prakarana Bhedad Paro Variyastvadivat. Nava Prakarana Bhedad Paro Variyastvadivat. So, na va. Or what? We have given Shabda. Shabda as Pramana we have given. But if you look at Prakarana as another Linga also, another indicator there, then, and here you can see that Prakarana is also Pramana there. Prakarana Bhedat, and there is Bheda. So, Na Va Prakarana Bhedat Paro Variyastvadivat is a single word. So, Prakarana Bheda is there. And due to that Prakarana Bheda, difference in Prakarana, Na what? Vidyaikyam na sambhavati. Like what? Paro variyastvadivat. So, paraha, avariya, these are the gunas of a particular devata, let's say. So, if you look at this prana, so there is paro variya, paro variyastva adivat. So, because of what? The meditation of Udgita, the Udgita Upasana, how it has to be done? As the Parovariya, as the greatest, the most superior Brahma. So, if you look at, we'll see more in the Vritti as to how this Parovariyastvam is seen. So, similar is this. Elsewhere, you see this Udgita Upasana has to be done as what? Udgita is the Parovariya. Has Parovariyastva, meaning is the most superior, has this the most superior gunas, meaning Brahma gunas. Udgita Upasana has to be done as to this Udgita itself is Parabrahma. And thereby, Prakarana Bheda will establish this. We'll see, in the Vritti we'll see more as to the Vidyas are not same, Upasanas are not same. Why? Because the prakaranas, the chapters or sections are different. Just like the Udhita Upasana where the gunas which we see as to Parovariya Ityadi, they will establish whether the Upasana is same or not. Similarly, here also you have to see what is the discussion in the Upasana. The chapters themselves are different, so you need not club them together, says the Siddhanti. In the Vritti, Naiva Vidyaikyam Yuktam. This oneness between two upasanas of this Prana Upasana or Udgita Upasana as the Purvapakshi sees, as quoted in the earlier sutra, they are not same. They are different in Brihad and they are इट इज डिफरेंट इन बृहद एंड छांदोग्य रेस्पेक्टिवली. कुतः प्रकरण भेदात बिकॉज द सेक्शंस आर डिफरेंट. एकत्र ओम इत्येतद् अक्षरम उद्गीत उपासीत इति उद्गीत अवयव ओंकारे प्राण दृष्टिर उपदिश्यते. अन्यत्र तु त्वं न उद्गाय इति या सकलैव सकला एव साम भक्तिः तस्याः कृतोद्गाता प्राणत्वेन आवेद्यते इति उपक्रम भेदात. सो उपक्रम इट्सेल्फ इज डिफरेंट. योर ओपनिंग यू आर लुकिंग एट द स्टोरी वेयर देर इज एन संग्राम. देर इज अ संग्राम बिटवीन देव एंड असुर. दिस इज वॉट यू दी पूर्वपक्षी इज लुकिंग एट. बट इफ यू लुक एट दी उपक्रम ऑफ दी प्रकरण सेक्शंस इन बोथ दी शाखाज इफ यू लुक एट दी उपक्रम प्रॉपर वॉट इज इट ओपनिंग विथ. इन दी उपासना वॉट इज द ओपनिंग देर नॉट दी स्टोरी. देर इज अ प्रकरण भेद. सो एकत्र इन वन प्लेस वॉट यू सी इन वन शाखा ओम इत्येतद् अक्षरम् उद्गीत उपासीत इति उद्गीत अवयवे ओंकारे. वी हैव सीन दिस अर्लियर एज टू ओंकार इज वन पार्ट ऑफ उद्गीत विच इज अ पार्ट ऑफ साम मंत्र. The Sama Gana, when it is done, there is an Udgita in which there is one part which is Omkara. Unto that Omkara, what should you do? Om iti etad aksharam Udgita upasita. Om is the name for Parabrahma, Ishvara's Nama. And that Om iti etad aksharam, this particular Om akshara, in that manner what? Udgita upasita. This Udgita should be meditated upon as Om. So unto that what has been said? Iti udgita avayave omkare. Om iti etar aksharam udgita upasita. This udgita Om, udgita antargata Om, if you look at udgita avayave omkare, what is taught? Prana drishtir upadishyate. That is prana. अन्यत्र तु त्वं न उद्गाय त्वं नः अस्माकं कृते उद्गाय. सो वाय डोंट नः अस्माकं कृते त्वं हे प्राणः त्वं हे नॉट हे प्राणः हे प्राण त्वं अस्माकं मते उद्गाय. यू डू उद्गान इति या सकल सकला एव सामभक्तिः. सो इफ यू लुक एट सामभक्ति द एंटायर साम तम उद्गाय उद्गाय उद्गान करता इज प्राण नाउ. सो वॉट शुड ही बी डूइंग प्राण. प्राण शुड बी सिंगिंग द एंटायर उद्गान. ही इज उद्गाता. ही इज गोइंग टू सिंग द एंटायर साम. सकला एव साम भक्ति ही द एंटायर पांच भक्ति का और सप्त भक्ति वॉट एवर इट इज द एंटायर साम ही इज गोइंग टू सिंग नाउ प्राण. बिकॉज दे आर सेइंग प्लीज सिंग. एंड देन फर्दर इट हैज बीन सेड ही सैंग तस्याः कर्तोद्गाता. So Udgata, who is a Karta? Karta Udgata, who is that? Tasyaha Samabhaktehe Karta. Kasa Pranaha. So Prana is Karta. So Samabhaktihi Gana Karta is Pranaha. So he is Udgata. Because he is seeing this Udgita. Thereby Pranatvena Avedyate. What has been said? This prana, as the prana itself, the karta, the singer of this sama, entire sama is prana. Iti upakrama bheda. There is a huge difference there in the upakrama itself. So your tatparyalinga is not working. That shadlinga English itself will not work here at all. Upakrama is different. Tatra drushtanta. Like what? Like parovaryastvadi. What? Like parovaryastvadi. What does that mean? यथा परमात्म दृष्टि अध्यास साम्येपि स एष परोवरीयान् उद्गीतः इति परोवरीयस्त्वादि विशिष्टम् उद्गीत उपासनम् अक्ष्यादि अक्ष्य अक्षी आदित्य अक्षी आदित्यगत हिरण्यश्मश्रुत्वादि विशिष्टोद्गीत उपासनात् भिन्नं तद्वत्. नाउ देयर आर उद्गीत उपासनास विच हैव कम अप अर्लियर. दिस उद्गीत उपासनास हाउ आर दे टू बी डन? As described, they have to be done in one prakarana, in one shakha, and in another prakarana, in another shakha, or in two different prakaranas in the same shakha. If the gunas are different, you cannot make क्लब मेक एंड क्लब देम टुगेदर इनटू सिंगल उपासना. व्हाई? लुक एट इट. तत्र दृष्टांत परोवर्यस्त्वादि दि श्रेष्ठ गुणाज ऑफ ब्रह्म गुणाज परब्रह्म गुणाज आर डिस्कस्ड इन वन सेक्शन. यथा परमात्म दृष्टि, दिस परमात्म दृष्टि परब्रह्म दृष्टि अध्यास साम्य. अध्यास इज सी अध्यास जनरली द शब्द अध्यास इन वेदांत प्रॉपर अद्वैत वेदांत वी सी अध्यास एज आरोप ऑल राइट बट ड्यू टू अविद्या हियर दिस इन उपासना अध्यास इज डन नोइंग दिस difference meaning we know if we know Rajju as Rajju and do Sarpadhyasa then it is not Adhyasa real, it is not Avidyakruta Adhyasa, but nobody is going to do that. So where is this Adhyasa? In Upasana. In Upasana if you look at the Shivalinga, Shivalinga is to be seen as Shiva himself. Or if you look at Salagrama, in Salagrama Vishnu Buddhi, Narayana Buddhi, Vishnu Buddhi, that is Adhyasa, but it is not due to Avidya, it is due to Shastra Vidhi. Shastra says you see Shiva in this stone, you see Vishnu in this particular stone. Both are stones of particular akara. A shape of linga to a particular stone gives a Shivalinga. So you do Shiva Adhyaropa, Adhyasa on that, and that is the Upasana. You will get a particular phala. So Shiva himself is superimposed, Bhagavan Shiva, onto that linga. Similarly, Bhagavan Vishnu is superimposed for Upasana purposes as described in the Shastra on to Salagrama. Salagrama is also stone found in Narmada Ityadi. So that is the Adhyasa here. So here Paramatma Drishti Adhyasa Samyapi. Although there is Paramatma Drishti in Udgita Vidya, still what? There is difference in Upasanas when you look at one mantra which says Sayesha Parovariya Parovariyan Udgitaha. This उद्गीता इज वॉट स एष परोवर्य परब्रह्म हिमसेल्फ इति परोवर्यस्त्वादि विशिष्टम उद्गीत उपासनम. देर इज वन उपासना वेर विशेषण इज वॉट दिस परब्रह्म गुणाज आर टू बी सीन, सुपीरियर गुणाज आर टू बी सीन इन उद्गीता, अ पार्ट ऑफ साम. दैट इज वन उपासना. यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू क्लब इट टू अनदर, क्लब इट विथ अनदर उपासना वेर अक्षी आदित्यगत हिरण्य श्मश्रुत्वादि विशिष्टोद्गीत उपासनात् भिन्नम. So this upasana, although it is Udgita upasana, another Udgita upasana elsewhere is what? Akshi Aditya Gata Hiranya Shmashrutvadi Vishishta. So that Udgita, which is also part of Sama, there in another place, what has the upasana been taught as? In the Akshi, Dakshina Akshi, in the right eye, there is one Purusha. That Udgita should be seen as such Purusha. Or what? Aditya Gata. In the Surya Mandala, there is one Hiranya Shmashru Devata. There is this Purusha who is also Paramatma only, of course. But that Paramatma Purusha is what? Has golden hue, he has golden mustache, etc. So that kind of an upasana is to be done on which particular entity? Udgita itself. Udgita should be seen in this manner. So Vishishta Udgita Upasana, this that is also Udgita Upasana. So when Udgita is seen as what? That Purusha who is in the Dakshinakshi or in the Dakshinakshini, or you see in the Surya Mandala, Aditya Gata, with golden hue, etc. All these gunas are different. So there you don't bring them together and do an upasana in this manner, because Parabrahma cannot have Hiranya Shmashru or cannot be seen as one who is in the eye, right eye of the upasaka. So there the two upasanas are different. One place the same Udgita is seen as Parabrahma with all the Parabrahma tattvas, Parovarya gunas, Parovaryastva gunas. In another case, you have to look at Hiranya Shmashrutva Ityadi or Akshigatattvam, Adityagatattvam, etc. of the same Udgita. However, this Udgita Vidya, Udgita Vidya name is not sufficient to club them together, because there is actual Swarupa Bheda in the Upasanas. So, although Udgita Vidya is a Samakhya Nama, which is same across two different places, still Guna Upasamhara has not been done, it is not accepted. Why? Because there is Swarupa Bheda in Upasana. Similarly, here also there is a Swarupa Bheda. In one case, Prana is the Udgana Karta. In another place, Prana is Udgata itself. Udgata, not Udgata. Udgata, the Omkara, Udgita, not Udgata, sorry, Udgita. In one place, he is Udgata, Udgana Karta. And in another place, he is Udgita itself. That Omkara, which is the Udgita Avayava Omkara. Their prana drishti has to be done. So if you look at it, Swarupa itself is different, therefore no Upasamhara has to be done tadvat. Similarly, here also, this is the reply in the 7th Sutra by Siddhanti. We look at more in continuation. There is no Sangati here. In continuation, what else has been said? That we will see in the next part. Amnayantika samsiddham adi madhyanta varjitam anandaghanam apurnam atma jyotir upasmahe. Namaste, dhanyavada.
धन्यवाद भाई जी, नमस्ते
नमस्ते।